This is a humble LED. It's a simple component that lights up when power supply is connected. It's a simple component that lights up when power supply is connected through a current limiting resistor. PWM can be used to control the brightness of the LED. While it is blinking on and off really quickly, our eyes don't see the blinking, but the constantly lit dimmer light instead. It's understandable to think that connecting a potentiometer to an ADC pin and passing the scaled ADC reading to a PWM output would make LED's brightness follow the potentiometer's position. But unfortunately, the LED is most of the time much brighter than one would think. In this video, I will go through why the brightness of the LED doesn't change the way one would think and also how to fix that. But first, quick thanks to the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. When projects are ready to move from breadboard to real PCB, PCBWay is my go-to place. You can get 10 double-sided 10x10cm PCBs for just $5 plus shipping. Completed solder mask, silk screen, and plated through holes. All of those are huge improvements compared to homemade PCBs for just a couple of bucks. And also, you don't need to play with chemicals used during etching. For all your prototype needs, go check out pcbway.com. The problem becomes clear when we want to programmatically control the brightness. This code increases the PWM duty cycle at constant rate, so the change of PWM value over time is linear. Still, the LED is bright most of the time. It is dim for a very short time in the beginning and then brightens quickly back to the near full brightness where it almost like stays the same for a while. The way human eye perceives light is not linear. Rule of thumb is light intensity needs to become about 4 times as high for the perceived light brightness to double. That's why the linear PWM duty cycle just looks wrong, as biggest visible brightness change happens at the low end. Perceived brightness is said to be about light intensity raised to the power of 1 over 2.2. To adjust the PWM value such way that the LED outputs linear perceived brightness, we need to take the desired brightness, which is value in range of 0 to 1, and raise it to the power of 2.2, and multiply max PWM value with that. That still keeps 0 input as 0 and 1 input as max PWM. But everything in between changes. From previous example, the fade from 0 to 100% looks like this. The fade is now quite even throughout the range. Arduino Nano has 10-bit ADC, giving values from 0 to 1023, and default PWM resolution of 8 bits, taking values from 0 to 255. To map ADC input to PWM output with previously mentioned correction, we get analog read on the pin divided by 1023 and that raised to the power of 2.2 and multiplied by 255. That can then be sent to the PWM pin with analog write. Now the brightness follows potentiometer's position correctly, or at least better than before. The 2.2 value can be adjusted slightly to match real-world conditions if it doesn't produce good results already. Here I have taken this one step further. I have second potentiometer and second LED. First potentiometer changes the brightness of both LEDs. Second one controls the balance of the two LEDs. Here's the code for this version. One LED's desired brightness is multiplied by second ADC value divided by 1023. And second LED's desired brightness is multiplied by 1 minus the second ADC value divided by 1023. Overall desired brightness doesn't change with that second potentiometer. It's still 1. There's not much point having two red LEDs side by side and controlling their balance. One project idea where this type of two-light dimmer with balance control would be useful is light controller with adjustable white balance. For example, this is one of the cheapest LED ring lights, probably bought from demo. These have cold white LEDs and warm white LEDs controlled separately. The temperature can be controlled by changing the ratio of warm and cold white LED's brightness. The first potentiometer would control brightness and second one would control temperature. I just got this light, so I don't know if I'm going to hack this or not. The original controller has just a couple of steps for both temperature and brightness. It may or may not be good enough. Time will tell. With 8-bit PWM, resolution isn't great, but this should give you some ideas how this method works. I hope this was helpful. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.